go. Proper battle for the first time. Doran anti-lag on his side of the grid. Oh, takes the clutch.
Travis gets the jump.
Yeah, Travis got a great start there. Subaru been testing jumps, starts extensively. They've been testing with Scott Speed, and it looks like they got it dialed. It's a real shame for Liam, they're having to dip the clutch.
That's right. All right, so well executed there by Travis Pastrana. He normally doesn't get the jump. He says he doesn't get the best start, and Liam goes for the Joker, and that's exactly what he talked about. If you don't get that jump, maybe go for the Joker. Nice, clean landing there by Pastrana as we go under the bridge where he drew some blood or drew some dust.
So let's get into tactics straight away in terms of Joker lap. So Travis has a choice now. If he feels he's faster than Liam, he'll stay out until the last lap and then he'll Joker. But for safety, and if he thinks Liam might close that gap down, and when you run wide like that, if I were Travis the spotter, I'd be going, you know what, Joker on the next lap, because it gives Liam less laps to try to close the gap. So Travis may well respond with a Joker straight away. Remember, the winner goes through, the loser's done for the day, and there's a championship point for every battle you win.
And a championship, that is a great point. And even with those by runs, we saw Timmy Hansen, 6.5 seconds between the two drivers. Liam really needs to get some gusto here and go for it. And we are seeing 7 seconds. So that gap is growing. What is Travis going to do?
Yeah, is Travis going to go Joker or not? No, he's got Travis. Nope. Yes, he is.
There he is.
Travis goes Joker, so splits off to the right. So now watch for Liam in the background. The gap was 7.1. Doran now coming up towards the big gap jump. Pastrana goes underneath. Going to come up for the merge. Where's Doran in the Audi?
He's coming up
for the inside line, but Pastrana's got it easily. So 7.1. Let's see what the gap
is
now.
Widespread by Travis.
Liam with a half spin in the background. So I was keen to see the gap, but with the mistakes from Liam, you can't. So that doesn't give us a delta. I reckon 5 seconds looking at that, Jared. I think five could be about right for Supercar.
Travis, he took a weird line, kind of got hung out there to drive. But Liam, as you said, kind of did a mid-spin, saved it, salvaged a run there. But look, it's shrinking, 3.86 seconds from Travis to Liam Doran.
Travis could just keep the door shut, though. You know, this is the thing. Now, a pass is hard work anyway. See the white flag? That's just to let you know you're on your last lap. Liam's a long, long way back. So interesting that Travis responded on lap two. I wonder, without the mistake after the step up, maybe he wouldn't have done. The other thing is, I'm not sure the spotters can see the backside of the course, so they may not have known that. And also, sometimes the driver chooses the Joker strategy for themselves, particularly if you're in a turn one fight.
And it looks like Travis has worked out his kinks, right? It seems like the car's running better. He's running clean. He's running tidier. Tires are staying within his vehicle. You know, we're talking about de-beating. But also, let it be known, one and done. You know, if you lose, you're out. This is moving on. This is bracket style, and you can accumulate more points as you progress through the brackets.
It's 4 championship points, Jared. You know, we talked earlier about backward losing the World Championship to Hansen on countback. They were on equal points. You go and ask him, and he'll tell you all the points where he missed out on 1 point. And it's not lost on these drivers. Get every point you can. So Travis is going to go through. He's going to take a championship point. Liam Doran, I'm afraid, is going to be done for today.
What are you afraid of?
Well, how disappointed Liam's going to be.
Liam's still going to have a smile on his face, going toe-to-toe. But look at this. Travis Pastrana and Liam, this is how it got done.
Liam, it was the start, I'm afraid, Jared. So the thing is here, it's pretty hard in terms of trying to figure out what RPM you want. So, you know, the tyres are sticky, the track's hot, particularly that tarmac section. I don't know what the track temperature is, but you need the RPM just right. Too high and you get too much wheel spin, too low and you bog. And on this occasion for Liam, it was probably 100, 200 RPM too low, but it didn't work out. Subaru, all that start testing looks to have paid off. That used to be their big weakness, but the WRX STI killed it off the start there. Great job.
Yeah, that was smooth like butter there. You could see him touching down, really compressing all of that suspension, and that is when he got the checkered flag. But guess what? Travis Pastrana wins this battle. First ever making history here, our bracket battle here at Nitro Rallycross.